Hi, I'm Diane Marie Collins, and you have entered the DM Zone. We are so excited. We are visiting here with Cindy Bradley, trumpeter. And as a female, that is a rare thing, isn't it? Here we're at Jazz. We're at Huntsville, Alabama. Welcome, Cindy.
Thank you for having me.
Please tell me, how is it? Because I know it's unusual for a woman to be a trumpeter. How did this happen?
Oh, well, how it happened to me was kind of a funny story. I was in elementary school in fourth grade, and I also took piano lessons at the time, but we were allowed to sign up to play an instrument in the school band, and I actually didn't want to. So I didn't sign up, and my teacher just absolutely relentlessly chased me around, saying, "You sure you don't want to sign up? You play the piano, you like music," and chased me. And finally one day I just said, "Fine, but I don't know what to play." And she said, just circle something on the paper. So I circled trumpet. I just, without any thought. And one thing that was really cool is that teacher, her name was Mrs. Senegulia, presented me with an award in my hometown last year.
Oh my
gosh. Yeah,
I love that.
She retired for decades, and she came, and she had no idea how she changed my life by just.
And obviously it was something that resonated with you, because I took piano too, and obviously I still don't play piano, but I mean, you know, it's the form of music and so on. But when you picked up the trumpet, and we have to talk about this gorgeous trumpet, when you picked up the trumpet, what was it?
Well, at first it didn't sound very good. It was hard. I liked it. I didn't really fall in love with it until I was a little bit older, in junior high and middle school, and I started playing in a jazz band. And there was actually a community band of all kids, and we played like big band swing music, like Glenn Miller and Tommy Dorsey and Harry James, and that's when I learned to.
I was gonna say
improvise. And
you suddenly realized.
Yeah. It took a little
what
while.
What this instrument could do.
Yeah. Yep.
Let's talk about this. The beautiful pink. This is made just for Cindy.
This was made just for me. This was made by Andy Taylor, who is the owner of Taylor Trumpets. He's in the UK, and he builds like the coolest instruments. He builds Batman trumpets with wings on them, and like, just if you go to taylortrumpets.com, you can see these just works of art. But he made a heart shape on the end, and everything's kind of just pink. He put my name in it. It's engraved. It's kind of hard to see, but, and I always love having what they call a raised bell, like Dizzy Gillespie had, just because I love the way it looks. So he put that on there for me too. But I got this in January, so it's relatively new.
Well, it's gorgeous. The other thing you have happening in your life, besides a relatively new trumpet, is a new album?
Yes, yeah.
Let's talk about that.
The new album came out on May 31st. It's called The Little Things, and it's doing really well, yeah. I'm excited about it.
What are some of the things that you do? Are they standards? What are they?
It's all original music. There's actually no standards on this one, so it's all music I wrote, or I wrote with the producer, and we collaborated, and yeah, it's all original.
Oh, that's amazing. That's exciting.
Yeah, it is. I love it. Yeah.
Because jazz is always a live thing, and it's always moving along, and a lot of people don't realize that. They keep thinking of what we talked about, the standards.
Right,
you know?
Right. And it's so different live than on the recording, too. Like people will hear the recording of a song and come hear it live and say, it didn't sound quite the same, because you're collaborating so much more.
It's not stage. Supposed to, but they I haven't got that yet.
It's different, but that's the beautiful part of it. always loved jazz, and I studied jazz in college. So I have a bachelor's degree in jazz studies, a master's degree in jazz performance. So I was studying jazz a lot. But the whole time I studied jazz in school, I was touring with funk bands. I toured with Gloria Gaynor and Sam Moore, like disco bands, and a lot of fusion and funk and things like that. So
that's kind of the fun thing. And you also teach. I mean, when you talk about seminars, now you've got another master's as well in teaching. Is that correct?
I have a master's in educational leadership, which is like administration. So I could be a principal or a supervisor. I'm not.
You're impressive.
Oh, thanks. I like school. I'm a school nerd. Always been a nerd.
When you tour, I know you're married. Do you get to tour often with your hubby?
Not often at all. My husband is, he's in a couple different
bands. You can say his name.
David Clark. And his band is called Songs in the Attic. And it's like the best Billy Joel tribute band I've ever heard. And my husband sounds like Billy Joel, kind of looks like him, plays the piano like him. And when I'm not playing with my own show, I do play in his band. And vice versa. He's played my shows too, but it's very rare right now that we're not. Like, he's working tonight with his band, and I'm working with mine, and it's a beautiful problem to have, but I think he's played one show with me where he's been available.
Well, we'll hope for more in the future.
Yeah, I hope so. Yeah.
I love it. And this has been a visit with Sydney Bradley, and you've been in the DM zone. Come back soon. Sydney Bradley playing I'm All Ears.
You can connect with me at cindybradley.com and on Facebook at facebook.com/cindybradleyjazz, Instagram, Cindy Bradley Jazz.
Let's welcome jazz trumpeter Sydney Bradley. We'll be right back.